Hello, and welcome to a new EasyDigitals.com video tutorial. Remember, you can get all of our high-quality Photoshop and Photoshop Elements templates at EasyDigitals.com. Just click on the Products button. And don't forget to sign up for our monthly newsletter. We give away free templates and tutorials each and every month, along with product update info and coupons. Okay, Kim, what easy tutorial are you going to show us today?
Okay, today I want to go over some of the fun things that you can do with the backdrops and show you how I accomplished some of the things that are in the sample pages. I'm going to show you how to get this look with two backdrops. I already have a tutorial on how to extract a player. This overlay is part of one of our free templates that you can get at EasyDigitals.com. In my other backdrop tutorial, I go over how to change the color of a backdrop. So I'm not going to go over that right now. So here's my two backdrops. You can either drag this over on top, or you can just right-click it, click Duplicate Layer, and find the document that you want to duplicate it to, which is number one right here, and click OK. And now I'm going to go ahead and get this one out of the way. All right, so now I have two layers here. I'm going to turn this off. Anytime you have a layer that has black or white in it, you can do a blending mode to make the black or the white completely disappear. So basically, I'm going to turn this back on and I'm going to set a blending mode for screen, and it will ignore anything black. Anytime you want the white to disappear, then you can use multiply. But in this case, it looks better with the screen. So that's the one I'm using. So then you basically just drag in or pull in your other template elements and you're all set. Okay, while I'm on this one, I'll go ahead and also show you how to put a picture behind that same one. So basically, I have this picture up and I'm just going to drag it over and press Shift and bring it up. Press Enter. So I'm going to come to my layers and I'm going to turn this one off. And I'm going to set this one to screen. And there's my player. Okay. Next, I want to work on this backdrop and this dancer. So basically, I'm going to drag her over. And hopefully your pictures will go in bigger than this. These are very small resolution photos. And on this one, I used multiply for the dancer, and then I did some adjustments, which I'll show you how to do. I'm just going to make this come out, and I'm going to change that layer to multiply. And as you can see, it's already done the effect, but you can see a little bit of the edges, which I don't want, and I also don't want to see this design behind her. Okay, so I have the layer selected with the dancer on it, and I'm just going to click this to add a mask. And the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to soften this edge so that you can't. So that you really can't see the transition. And then I'm going to add a new layer and put it underneath, and the white will make her show more. So I'm going to just add some white wherever I don't want the background to show on this new layer. I like the template showing through her legs, so I'm not going to do as much on that area. I'm just going to leave that the way it is and just come in here and work on her face and her hands. I don't mind the background being blended into that. I'm going to get my eraser tool and erase a little bit of this. I'm hitting my right bracket again. And just, I need a soft edge. Just erasing the white. So as you can see, you can have a lot of fun with these backdrops when working with the blending modes. Try to experiment with it and have some fun with it. And I always like to see what you guys do with these templates and these backdrops, so please drop me a line, show me what you've done, and if you want to, we can put it in the showcase.
Hey, that was easy. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions about this tutorial or any of our products, you can always reach us at easydigitals.com. Have yourself a creative day.